Mistakes happen, especially in software development. Fortunately, making mistakes is often the best way to learn. So today we'll fix a minor mistake that I made in the previous jump tutorial and learn from it. But I want to give the biggest shout out to an awesome community member, Peonso, for pointing out and explaining my mistake and why it's a problem. So thank you and be sure to show him some love in the comments. Welcome back to iHeartGameDev, my channel all about game development. Now, let's get started. In the previous video of this series, how to jump in Unity 3D, jumping like Mario, we updated our animation and movement controller script to include jumping. We made the decision to use Velocity Verlet Integration instead of the simpler alternative, Euler Integration. More specifically, we made this decision for movement on the Y axis, which is our jump and our gravity. Be sure to check out the previous videos in this series to get a full understanding up to this point. But to summarize our reasoning, Velocity Verlet Integration is more accurate than Euler Integration because our jump would not be impacted by the frame rate of our game. Whether the game runs at 30 frames per second, 60 frames per second, 120 frames per second, the character will always reach the same exact height. But we cannot say the same for Euler integration. The difference in height is minor with Euler integration, but it is there. How does Velocity Verlet Integration get this consistency? Well, we know that gravity is applied every frame of the game. So what Velocity Verlet Integration does is save the previous velocity, then calculate a new velocity by taking the previous velocity value and adding a gravity value that's been multiplied by the time step. And the last step is adding the new and previous velocities together and multiplying by 0.5 to average them. Velocity Verlet Integration states that this calculated average is the value that we should apply to our position every frame. And if we take a look at our handle gravity method, this is actually exactly what we're doing in our current implementation. We set a variable previous y velocity equal to the current movement y value, which is stored at the class level and reused every frame. Then we create a new variable titled new y velocity that is equal to the current movement y value plus the incremental gravity. We then create a third variable titled next y velocity, which performs the averaging of the previous y velocity and the new y velocity. However, here's where the mistake comes in. We set our current movement y value equal to the average. And we do so because current movement is what moves the position of the character with the character controller's move method in the update function. But this also means in the next frame, the average is what's going to be considered the previous y velocity. This is wrong. What we should be doing is applying the average velocity like we currently are to the character controller's position, but saving the calculated new y velocity for the next frame. So to reiterate, we are saving the next y velocity, which is the average of the two velocities, and that's what's being used in the next frame's handle gravity method, but it's not supposed to be. The average is only supposed to be used in the actual movement. We're supposed to save the new y velocity, which is the velocity that just adds gravity. Okay, let's fix this issue. Previous y velocity will stay the exact same, setting it equal to the current movement y value. Then, instead of creating a brand new variable titled new y velocity, we'll just set current movement y value to the calculated velocity value that adds gravity. But now, we need to set the average of these velocities to a new variable. And remember, this is the one that needs to be applied to our movement in the character controller's move function, so it has to be defined within the class and not the method. At the very top of this file, we have our current movement and current run movement vector 3 variables. Here, we'll create a third vector 3 titled applied movement. And this is the variable that we will set equal to the calculation back in handle gravity. And we'll just delete the current movement and current run movement lines because we won't need them after the next change. And remember to replace new y velocity with current movement.y because new y velocity does not exist anymore. We will need to use this applied movement variable in the character controller's move function to actually move the character. So in our update function, we can see that we are either using the current run movement or current movement variables with the character controller's move method. But we now need to use our applied movement variable because it's storing the average Y velocity that needs to be applied to the character. No problem. We'll just delete the current usage of the character controller's move methods. And instead, we'll set the applied movement's X and Z values equal to the current movement and current run movement's X and Z values, depending on if the run button is pressed or not. Now, all we need to do is use the character controller's move method with the applied movement multiplied by time.delta time. Okay, entering play mode and attempting to jump, we'll notice that the jump is incredibly short. We can fix this quite easily. Looking at our handle jump function, we'll remember that we added a 0.5 multiplier to the initial jump velocity. This is no longer necessary because we are properly using Velocity Verlet integration. Additionally, we'll need to replace the current run movement here with the applied movement so that the initial jump velocity is actually used in the character controller's move method and Jammo will jump. Entering play mode and we will now see Jammo jumping correctly. And this time, Jammo is truly using Velocity Verlet integration as intended. One last note is that we want to set the applied movement Y value in handle gravity to the grounded gravity when the character is grounded, because applied movement is always being used to control the character's movement now. And we can easily modify the jump height using our max jump height variable thanks to our logic from the previous episode. Awesome. We fixed it and solidified our understanding of Velocity Verlet integration in the process. Of course, if you are a patron, you can access the updated fixed files over on patreon.com/iHeartGameDev. And a huge thank you for supporting this channel. We'd love to have more amazing developers join this community. Be sure to check out the link for the Discord channel through the description. The next videos will be a welcomed refactor of our current script to use state machines, and then an entire video dedicated to Cinemachine. I also want to say that I'm so grateful to have such an awesome community of people who are not only willing to watch these videos, but to also share their own knowledge. Thank you again, Peonso. This was honestly a great experience for me and solidified my personal understanding of Velocity Verlet integration. But that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.